From Haven Center on the campus of Benilde St. Margaret's School in St. Louis Park, Park TV 16 Sports presents High School Volleyball featuring the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights. Hi everybody, this is Howard Woolock, welcoming you to our opening volleyball match of the 2015 season as the De La Salle Islanders take on the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights. The De La Salle Islanders go into tonight's match with a record of 1-0. They opened the season on April 27th with a 3-0 win over the Minneapolis South Tigers. The Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights, under veteran head coach Bong Wung, played in the Side-Out Classic on Saturday, August 29th against the St. Michael Albertville Knights, and they were swept by the Knights 3-0. They have a record of 0 wins and 1 loss.
The starters, number 5, Marit Gomranson.
As the players are being introduced, all of us at Park TV would like to extend our condolences to the family and friends of Greg Herman. Greg is the father of the Benilde St. Margaret's volleyball player, Kate Herman. Greg passed away last week. So everybody here at Park TV and to everyone connected with Benilde St. Margaret's School as well at St. Louis Park, we offer our condolences to the family and friends of Greg Herman. It was an emotional loss for the Red Knight girls volleyball team. The last season finished 20-8, losing in the Section 6 3A quarterfinals. Correction, the semifinals to the Wayzata Trojans. The Trojans are expected to be one of the top teams this season under head coach Scott Jackson. The officials for tonight's match are a sister act, Deb and Nora Smith. For those of you tuning in to girls high school volleyball for the first time, each game is played up to 25 points except the fifth set, which is played to 15. A team must win by a margin of at least 2, and it's rally scoring all the way. As we are finding out who will be serving first in tonight's match, coming in is a libero for the Red Knights, Emma Sather. Sather, one of the co-captains along with Paige Mizell. And we are underway with the opening match of the home season for the Red Knights. As nobody is home for the Islanders, the Red Knights are on the board. We're glad you can join us from Haven Center in St. Louis Park. And it's an ace for Sather. 2 in a row for the Red Knights. And it's 3 in a row. De La Salle not generating a lot of offense in the early going as well as defense, as Benilde St. Margaret's is on a 3-0 run in the early going of the opening set. And it's another race. If there was one thing Fong Wong was stressing in our pregame interview, was to cut down on the number of service errors that happened against St. Michael Albertville. They have done so far because the Red Knights are on a 4-0 run. That's Kleinschmidt. And a retreat, and it goes out of bounds off of the libero for the Islanders. 5 in a row for the Red Knights. That's Kleinschmidt. And a block in the front by Paige Mizell. Six in a row for Benilde St. Margaret's. Olivia Travis playing on the left front line for the Islanders. And a good play on the left front for Sophie Hathaway. Seven in a row for Benilde St. Margaret's. As head coach Jarrell Tate calls timeout for De La Salle. By the way, if you would like to order a copy of tonight's non-conference girls volleyball match between De La Salle and Benilde St. Margaret's, it's very easy to do. Go to www.parktv.org or you can phone our viewer hotline at 952-924-2631. That's 952-924-2631, where you could talk to our producer-director, Paul Broden, who's punching up the pictures for tonight's match in the control truck for Park TV. And so far, it's been all Benilde St. Margaret's in the early going. 7 points in a row, including a couple of service aces for Emma Sather. Not much offense to speak of for De La Salle, as they have two players on the front line, Paris Smith and Olivia Travis. And it's another service ace for Sather. She is showing accuracy on her serving. Three service aces in the opening set. Eight in a row for the Red Knights. That's Kleinschmidt. Now that's Hannah Miller. And a block on the right side. And for the first time, the Islanders are on the board, ending an 8-0 run for Benilde St. Margaret's. Ella Heineman will be serving for De La Salle, located near the Mississippi River in Minneapolis. As the ball goes out of bounds, last touched by Sather, two in a row for the Islanders. We're starting to show a little bit of life here in the first set. There's a kill from Paige Mizell going off an Islander. Anna Lung enters the set for the Red Knights. Anna is the daughter of head coach Fung Lung. Fung was telling me that it was a little bit tough as a coach as well as a parent to coach her own daughter. That was Gulbrandson in the back row. Travis. And the shot going out of bounds by Paige Mizell. A point for De La Salle. Now, if the name Travis sounds familiar for De La Salle, Olivia Travis, a 6-foot sophomore, is the sister of two former De La Salle Islanders who are best known for basketball. Jonah Travis, who later went on to Harvard, and Reed Travis, who we'll talk about a little bit later, as De La Salle has two in a row and a net violation. A 5-point Red Knight lead. Reed Travis was the most recent of the Travis family to go Division I, playing basketball for the Stanford Cardinal in California. Reed was also an outstanding football player. He was a quarterback until he got injured during AAU ball. Opening up the door for Billy Hart and an ace for the Islanders. A 4-0 run for De La Salle, who was down at 1 point by 8. The ball goes into the net. as the Islanders have switched to a 3-1-2 offense. That's slung near the baseline. A back bump from Mizell. And a block goes into the net. It's down to one for the Red Knights. 9-8 as we take another look at that last play. The ball going into the net on a block. That's one. Nobody was up. The ball goes into the middle. The number 26. We're unable to find the number anywhere. Another point for the Red Knights. We're up by three. Serving is 26. Left-handed serve. Kleinschmidt. Sidearm. And a violation on the Islanders. The Red Knights are up by four. That's Kleinschmidt. But she's called over the net, resulting in a Red Knight point. The lead is five. Olivia Brimicum on the shot that goes out of bounds and the point for Benilde St. Margaret's. Last season finished 20-8 overall, losing in the Section 6 3A tournament to the Wayzata Trojans. That's Kleinschmidt on the set. Goes out of bounds and a point for the Red Knights. The lead is 7, 15-8 as we take another look at the kill that goes out of bounds. Kleinschmidt. And they double up the Islanders. 16-8. And De La Salle will take their second time out. The Red Knights with an 8-point lead. But getting back to Reed Travis, he was an outstanding athlete for the Islanders, excelling not only in basketball, but also excelling in football. But during the AAU basketball season, his senior year, he injured his ankle, so he sat out football, opening up the door for Billy Hart at quarterback, and he led the Islanders into the state tournament, even beating the Red Knights in the section finals. De La Salle advanced into the section champion, to the state championship, losing to Becker in the 4A final. Billy Hart turned out to be an outstanding quarterback. Can Olivia Travis follow in the footsteps of Jonah and Reed and establish a legacy on the basketball court? But there will be a new coach in the upcoming season because Faith Johnson Patterson is the new head girls basketball coach at Eden Prairie. Meanwhile, back to volleyball as the Red Knights look to increase their lead, which is now 8. There is a net violation on the Islanders. The lead is now 9. net violation going over the net. Couple of times that De La Salle has gone over the net. The lead is up to 10. And a block on the left side. A net violation against De La Salle. The lead is now 11. And a service ace, the ball trickling into the net, and then nobody can get the ball for the Islanders, as the Red Knights are 5 points away from winning the first set. The ball goes into the wall. At one point it was 9-8 in favor of Bunnell St. Margaret's. Now they have scored 12 consecutive points. Good block on the right side by Hannah Miller. 3 points to go. It is now 22-8. Head coach Jarrell Tate directing the troops for the Islanders. The ball hit the ground first, so it's a point for De La Salle, ending a 13-point run for Bunnell St. Margaret's. Ryan Satry will be serving for the Islanders. The ball goes out of bounds. Two in a row for the Islanders. The ball going by Kleinschmidt. That's long on the set. And a kill for Long. 2 points to go for Bunnell St. Margaret's. Long on the back set. Kleinschmidt drives it. Goes out of bounds, and a point for De La Salle. The lead is now a dozen. Leah Balke coming in for the Islanders. She is one of five juniors for head coach Jarrell Tate. Goes off an Islander. Set point, Red Knights. Hannah Miller to serve for the Red Knights. The Islanders bounce back and Gabrielle Ewell will serve for De La Salle. Ewell, one of four seniors on the Islanders. Miller. Mazzell with the kill. The first set goes to the Bunnell St. Margaret's Red Knights, 25-12. We will take a break and we'll be back with the second set of tonight's girls volleyball match featuring the De La Salle Islanders and the Bunnell St. Margaret's Red Knights. You're watching High School Girls Volleyball on Park TV 16.
Introducing a breakthrough in time management technology. A whole new day of the week. It's called Someday. Ingenious. Perhaps someday you are going to go skydiving. Enter a hot dog eating contest. Maybe ride a mechanical bull. Now, it's on the calendar. You may want to retire someday. Ready for that? You'll really want this. A My Social Security account at socialsecurity.gov. You can estimate your future benefits, plan for your retirement, and how to save for it. If you already receive benefits, you can manage them online. Millions of people already have a My Social Security account. In fact, someone opens one about every 6 seconds. Get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
Hola, back at the Haven Center Sauna in St. Louis Park on the campus of Benilde St. Margaret's School. And why a sauna? Because, to put it to you this way, it is hot. There's a lack of air conditioning in the gym, but there are a couple of fans oscillating on the sides of the volleyball court here at Haven Center. On the subject of volleyball, the Red Knights enter the second set, winning the first one 25-10. They started on an 8-0 run. Then the Islanders came back and outscored the Red Knights 8-1, but Benilde St. Margaret's pulled away to win the first set 25-12 as the Islanders serve first in the second set. There's a block in the center from Maisie Jackson. De La Salle takes its first lead of the match. The ball going out of bounds. Kleinschmidt serving for the Islanders. But there is an illegal formation called on the Red Knights. Two in a row for the Islanders. As the official is talking to head coach Fung Lung of why the violation occurred. Jackson. Kleinschmidt on the left side and a high hit off the ceiling. Three in a row for the Islanders as Lung was unable to make the play. That's Lung on the right side. And a kill from Jackson. The Red Knights are on the board. A good play on the left side by Maisie Jackson. And she will get to serve for the Red Knights. That's Kleinschmidt. A block on the right side. That's Lung on the set. Lung sends it over the net. Goes off a Red Knight. The shot was by Paris Smith. It's a 3-point lead for De La Salle. Balke is back in for the Islanders. De La Salle, a member of the Tri-Metro Conference. The ball goes out of bounds and the Islanders are up by 4. Lung. That's Miller who bumped it over. And a block on the left side by Gulbrandsen goes out of bounds. Marek Gulbrandsen on the block, but it didn't stay in bounds. De La Salle is up by 5. The ball goes out of bounds on the service error. The Red Knights get the ball back. Paige Mizell to serve for Benilde St. Margaret's. Rachel Folkestead is in for the Red Knights. Some good passing in the front line for De La Salle as they go up by 4. Gabrielle Yule back in for the Islanders. The serve goes out of bounds and a point for the Red Knights. Maddie Markley, one of 5 sophomores for head coach Feng Lung, enters for Benilde St. Margaret's. They also score 2 points in a row. The lead is down to 3. Kleinschmidt on the back set. Into the net. The lead is down to 2 as the Red Knights are starting to pick up momentum in the second set. Hannah Miller serving for the Red Knights. A cross pass. Not a very good bump as the ball goes out of bounds and it's a point for the Islanders. Ryan Satry back in for De La Salle. Three consecutive service errors for the Islanders. Maisie Jackson comes back in for the Red Knights. Anna Carr takes a breather. Kleinschmidt near the net. The ball goes into the net by Heinemann. A point for the Red Knights. It's now a 1-point De La Salle lead. Kleinschmidt sends it toward the net. It's all even at 8. The first tie of tonight's match. De La Salle regains the lead. Gabrielle Yule on the kill. Olivia Brimacombe back in for the Islanders. Kleinschmidt. A service error on the Red Knights and a point for De La Salle. Manny Markley assessed with a cert of the error. A net violation on the Red Knights. On the Islanders, it's a 2-point lead, 1-point lead. They just changed the score. Jackson. Hannah Miller. Nobody was home. It's all even at 10. Second tie of the second set. And a block on the right front by Mizell. De La Salle regains the lead. Olivia Travis back in for the Islanders. One of two sophomores for De La Salle, the other is Gwen Kelly. A 2-point lead for De La Salle. As Ewell will continue to serve. The Red Knights cut it to one. Fung Lung was mentioning that their passes weren't very crisp against St. Michael Albertville, as well as their serving. It's all even at 12. Third tie of the set. The set's been tied at 8, 10, and 12. A double hit on the Islanders, as well as a carry. The Red Knights go in front for the first time in the set. And it's all even at 13. Tie number four. In the first set, Bunnell St. Margaret's won by a score of 25-12. The second set is a lot closer, all even at 13. Nobody was home at a point for the Islanders, who regained the lead. Kleinschmidt will serve for De La Salle. It's a net serve. It's tie number five, this time at 14. They watch it go out, the Red Knights regain the lead. Second time the Red Knights have led in the second set. Maisie Jackson serving for Bunnell St. Margaret's. Long sends it over. Kleinschmidt. The ball goes out of bounds. It's a 2-point lead for the Red Knights. So far, it's their largest lead of the set. Kleinschmidt with the back set. Goes off of Sather, the libero. And a point for the Islanders. With Bounty back in for De La Salle. De La Salle last season finished with a record of 17-9, losing to the Maple Lake Irish in the Section 4 AA tournament. Maple Lake, one of the top teams in Class 2A, led by their outstanding setter, Lindsay Rachel. And it's tie number six at 16. The Red Knights regain the lead as the Islanders are having problems with serves in the second set. The last one going into the net. Kleinschmidt. A block on the right side by Miller. Miller with a right-handed hook goes out of bounds. And it is tie number 7 at 17. Goes off of Lung. The Islanders regain the lead as Lung was called for the carry. Back and forth volleyball tonight in the second set. That's Lung. Hannah Miller on the kill. Tie number 8, this time at 18. Miller on the serve. The ball goes out of bounds. De La Salle regains the lead as Satry returns for De La Salle. The ball goes out of bounds. A 2-point lead for the Islanders as Fung Lung will call timeout. The first of 2 timeouts in the second set. Whenever the score is even at 23, each team gets an extra timeout. A lot of action coming up on the athletic scene for both Benilde St. Margaret's and St. Louis Park on Thursday, September 3rd. As both football teams are in action, St. Louis Park is at Spring Lake Park and Benilde St. Margaret's is at Irondale. But coming up Thursday night on Park TV 16, we will have St. Louis Park High School Soccer as they wrap up a 3-game stretch against the Lake Conference when they host the Minnetonka Skippers, girls at 5 and the boys at 7 p.m. Playback times, please go to parktv.org. As the ball goes out of bounds, it's a 4-point lead for, a 3-point lead for De La Salle. And a kill from Maddie Markley. Maisie Jackson back in for the Red Knights. There have been 8 ties in the second set. Miller on the back set. And a block by Kleinschmidt resulting in an Islander point. They are 3 points away from tying the match at 1. Two points to go for the Islanders. As Fung Lung will call the second timeout of the second set. The Red Knights trail by 4, 23-19. It's the first of 3 possible meetings between Benilde St. Margaret's and De La Salle. Since the two schools could meet again in in-season tournaments, both De La Salle and Benilde St. Margaret's will be playing on September 12th in the Coon Rapids tournament, and De La Salle will come to Benilde St. Margaret's when they host their tournament on October 10th. Among the teams participating in the tournament are St. Cloud Apollo, Holy Angels, Holy Family Catholic, Monomedi, Simley, Set Point, De La Salle. Miller. There will be a fourth set on a carry. The De La Salle Islanders win the second set, 25-19. We will take a break and we'll be back with the third set of tonight's match between the De La Salle Islanders and the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights. You're watching Girls High School Volleyball on Park TV 16.
I'm 5'11".
Barely 5'4".
I weigh about 170 pounds.
Brown eyes.
Blue eyes.
Brown hair.
Gray hair.
I'm a baseball fanatic.
I'm a wife.
A mom.
A sister.
And a grandfather.
I'm a bodybuilder.
I'm a research analyst.
Small business owner.
Teacher.
Dance fitness instructor.
Film and television actor.
I'm an office clerk.
I'm a copywriter.
I'm a veteran.
I have a prosthetic leg.
I have multiple sclerosis.
I have lupus.
Cerebral palsy.
Post-traumatic stress disorder.
I'm blind.
And I'm working in a job I love.
I love.
Because I was given a chance.
Because I was given a chance.
To contribute my skills and talents.
To show my disability is only one part of who I am.
Who I am.
Who I am.
At work, it's what people can do that matters.
For more information, visit whatcanyoudocampaign.org.
Center on the Benilde St. Margaret's campus in St. Louis Park. As we head into the third set of the best 3 out of 5 match with both the De La Salle Islanders and the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights all even at 1. Benilde St. Margaret's winning the first set 25-12 and De La Salle winning the second 25-19. Well, to quote a title of a Billy Idol song from the 80s, "It's Hot in the City Tonight," which describes the gym here because there is no air conditioning, but there are a couple of fans going. As the third set gets underway, Hannah Miller. The ball goes out of bounds. The Red Knights take the early lead. Emma Sather serving for the Red Knights. Nobody was going after the ball. Two in a row for the Red Knights. That's Travis. Miller with a back set. The Islanders around the board. Balky back in for the Islanders. She will also serve. The ball remains in bounds. The Red Knights are up by 2. Lung will serve for the Red Knights. Schmidt. A violation on the Islanders. It's a 3-point lead for the Red Knights. A good block by Hannah Miller. And the point for the Red Knights. The lead is now 4. Harris Smith on the kill. Cuts the lead to 3 as Gabrielle Yule returns to the match. Maddie Duffy, the libero, serving 2 in a row for De La Salle. Lung. Cross set to Miller. The ball goes out of bounds. And it's 3 in a row for the Islanders. They have doubled up the Red Knights. Down to 4. Goes into the net. It's a 2-point lead for Benilde St. Margaret's. Maisie Jackson is back in for Benilde St. Margaret's. The lone freshman for head coach Feng Wang. Heinemann on the kill that goes out of bounds. It's a 3-point lead for the Red Knights. Lung. Kleinschmidt in the back set. And the block by Miller, resulting in a Red Knight point. They have doubled up the Islanders. Harris Smith. Goes out of bounds, the lead is 5. Harris Smith gave quite a bit of hustle, but the ball went out of bounds, the lead is 5-9-4. Kleinschmidt. Kleinschmidt on the set. Harris Smith on the hit, picked up by Lung. Goes out of bounds and a point for De La Salle. Satry is back in for the Islanders and she will serve. Sather. Goes out of bounds, the lead is down to 3. Both teams will have their next matches at home against schools from the Minneapolis City Conference on September 3rd. The Red Knights will host the Minneapolis Southwest Lakers. De La Salle will host the Minneapolis Washburn Millers. It's a 4-point lead for the Red Knights, 10-6. A good block by Miller. The lead is 5. Miller. A net violation called on the Red Knights. A point for the Islanders. Brimacombe is back in for the Islanders. A back set to Miller. And a kill for Miller. A 5-point lead for Dela for the Red Knights, 12-7. A sidearm hit by Kleinschmidt, resulting in an Islander point. Do we have a replay of that, Paul? And we do, as you watch the sidearm hit by Sarah Kleinschmidt, which results in a point for De La Salle. But the Red Knights get the ball back. Manny Duffy, the libero, is in for the Islanders. In for the Red Knights. Sophie Hathaway. 13-9 in favor of the Red Knights. Miller on the back set. And a point for the Red Knights. Manny Markley on the kill. And Sather with a save. Kleinschmidt on the back set. Miller. Grimacombe on the kill, resulting in a De La Salle point. It's a 4-point lead for the Islanders, 14-10. As Balky will serve. Miller misses the ball, 2 in a row for De La Salle. The lead is down to 3. Good block by Manny Markley. A 4-point lead for the Red Knights. Lung will serve. Now 5. As Lung gets the ball back for her next serve. Kleinschmidt. Now Miller. A block on the right side by Grimacombe and a point for De La Salle. Gabrielle Ewell is back in for the Islanders. Miller's shot goes into the net, two in a row for the Islanders. As more fans come into Haven Center. Three in a row for De La Salle. And it's now 16-14 in favor of the Red Knights. Sophie Hathaway on the kill. As Fong Lung sends in a couple of substitutions, Maisie Jackson and Marit Gulbrandsson. Kleinschmidt goes off of Lung and into the front row of bleachers. It is now a 2-point lead for Benilde St. Margaret's. Thackeray will serve for the Islanders. There's a block taken in the back row by Balke. Kleinschmidt. A good block by Ella Heinemann. As De La Salle is roared back to cut the lead to one. Lung sends it over. A center block by Mizell. The lead is back to two as we take another look at the block, center block by Mizell. Rachel Folkestead is back in for the Red Knights. Mizell will serve. Sidearm hit by Kleinschmidt. Net violation on the Islanders. The lead is now three. Ewell on the net violation for De La Salle. She ran into the net. Goes into the front row of bleachers. Timeout for De La Salle. Their first timeout of the third set. And while we have a timeout, here's a look at the top 10 teams in Class 3A girls volleyball. The number one team is the Champlain Park Rebels, followed by four teams from the South Suburban Conference. Egan second, Prior Lake third, Lakeville South fourth, and the Rosemount Irish fifth. Hopkins is sixth, Roseville is seventh, the Creighton and Durham Hall Raiders are eighth, and two Lake Conference teams round out the top 10. Wyzetta ninth, and the Eden Prairie Eagles 10th. And speaking of Eden Prairie, that's where the Benilde St. Margaret's boys soccer team is tonight, taking on one of the top teams in Class AA boys soccer, the Eden Prairie Eagles. The number one Class 2A team is the Belle Plaine Tigers. The Stuartville Trojans are second, followed by Casson Manorville third, Maple Lake fourth, New Life Academy fifth, Hill Murray sixth, Jordan seventh, Kenyon Wanamingo eighth, Thief River Falls is ninth, and rounding out the top 10, the Cannon Falls Bombers. We'll have the Class 1A rankings a bit later. Goes out of bounds. The kill by Heineman goes out of bounds, and it's a 5-point lead for the Red Knights. By Kleinschmidt, 3 points to go for Benilde St. Margaret's. Kleinschmidt, a center block by Layla Duda. But it goes under the net. The ball goes back to De La Salle. Jackson with a serve, with a skill that goes out of bounds. Two in a row for the Islanders. Long. The Red Knights are 2 points away from taking a 2-1 lead in the match. Miller will serve. Goes into the net. Set point, Benilde St. Margaret's. De La Salle is still alive. Ewell will serve for De La Salle. Miller. Inbounds. The Red Knights are one set away from taking the match. This time, they win by the exact same score as the second set, 25-19. We will take a break and we'll be back with a fourth and possibly deciding set of tonight's girls volleyball match between the De La Salle Islanders and the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights. You're watching Girls High School Volleyball on Park TV 16.
This stage is nowhere near Broadway, and none of these actors will be accepting an Oscar anytime soon. Still, they are rehearsing for something important. While they learn their lines, they're also learning teamwork, discipline, self-confidence, that everyone has a part to play. Skills that will make them stars long after the curtain falls. The National Federation of State High School Associations reminds you that when kids take part in high school activities, they get set for life.
Howard Luloff back at Haven Center on the Benilde St. Margaret's campus in St. Louis Park, where the host Red Knights have a 2-1 lead in the best 3 out of 5 sets. The Red Knights coming back to win the third set by the exact same score as the second, 25-19. Here's a look at the top 10 teams in Class 1A girls volleyball. The number one team is Faribault Bethlehem Academy, followed by Tracy Milroy second, Mayor Lutheran is third, Mabel Canton fourth, Heritage Christian Academy is fifth, the Ada Borup Cougars are sixth, Kitson Central in Northwest Minnesota is seventh, Waterville Legion Morristown is eighth, Wabasha Kellogg is ninth, and Belgrade Bruton El Rosa is 10th as De La Salle takes the early lead in the fourth set. If Belgrade Bruton El Rosa sounds familiar in high school sports, they've had a successful boys basketball team the last couple years under the leadership of Dave Montbrine, winning two state titles. As there's a net violation on the Red Knights, two in a row for the Islanders to start the fourth set. Kleinschmidt. A sidearm hit by Hathaway. The Red Knights are on the board. They cut the lead to 2-1 as Anna Lung returns for the Red Knights. Lung, the daughter of head coach Fung Lung. Miller recovers it on a block. That was by Brimacombe. And a kill from Harris Smith. It's a 2-point lead for the Islanders, 3-1. Here's another look at the kill by Harris Smith. Going over a couple of Red Knights on the left front line. A high hit. The Islanders are up by 3. Goes into the net, but retrieved by Wong. But the ball goes out of bounds, and a point for De La Salle. And it's now a 5-1 lead. Lung. Miller's shot goes into the net. If there was one thing that Fung Lung was mentioning about, and we'll talk about as the Red Knights take timeout, was one thing that was a problem for the Red Knights in their opening match against St. Michael Albertville. They weren't passing crisply and their serving wasn't as crisp. They were having a lot of service errors. So far in the fourth set, they're not having a lot of key hits. Balls are going into the net. And while we have a timeout, if you would like to order a copy of tonight's girls volleyball match between De La Salle and Benilde St. Margaret's, go to www.parktv.org or phone our viewer hotline at 952-924-2631. The Benilde St. Margaret's girls soccer team is outside tonight in a key non-conference matchup against the perennial power Blake Bears. Kleinschmidt. Harris Smith on the kill. The lead is now 6. 5 consecutive points for the Islanders. Goes out of bounds and a point for the Red Knights. Ella Heineman sent the ball out of bounds and went a little bit too far. The lead is 5. Gulbrandson with the serve for the Red Knights. Klein Schmidt. The ball goes below the net and a point for the Islanders. 6-point lead for De La Salle, 8-2. The Red Knights cut the lead to 5. Miller. Not a good hit by Mizell and a point for the Islanders. As Heinemann will serve 9-3 in favor of De La Salle. Heinemann's serve goes into the net. Markley back in for the Red Knights. Two in a row for Benilde St. Margaret's. Goes out of bounds. The Red Knights are battling back. And trail 9-6 with Miller still serving. Heinemann on the kill, a point for De La Salle. Grimacombe back in for the Islanders. Miller. Maisie Jackson on the kill. The Red Knights get the ball back. As 26 goes in as well as Sophie Hathaway. There is no 26 in the program. The ball goes into the front row of bleachers. The lead is down to 2. 10-8 Islanders. Klein Schmidt. Heinemann on the kill. The Islanders battle back to return to a 3-point lead, 11-8, as we take another look at the kill by Heinemann. Miller near the baseline. There's a block on the right side, and it goes out of bounds. Good frontline play by the Red Knights as Layla Duda goes to the bench. 'Sather back in. A good sidearm hit by Olivia Travis. It's a 3-point lead for De La Salle, 12-19. The two schools were rivals for years in the late Don Bosco Conference. and they're still rivals on the basketball court. Goes into the net, a point for the Red Knights. It is 12-10, De La Salle. Klein Schmidt. A block in the front by Miller, as well as Mizell. It is now a 1-point Islander lead. We take another look at the block by Mizell and Miller. Two M's on the block. Heinemann on the kill. It's back to a 2-point De La Salle lead, 13-11 as we take another look at Heinemann's kill. The seniors having an outstanding match for De La Salle. Lund. And there's a block that goes out of bounds. As the Islanders possess a tall front line with Kleinschmidt and Travis. That's Travis on the block. Miller. The lead is 4. Satry is serving. Lung. And a serve by Mizell. Jackson and Gulbrandsen are back in for the Red Knights with Gulbrandsen serving. But it's a net serve. And the point for the Islanders. As serving continues to be an Achilles heel for Benilde St. Margaret's. Jackson on the kill. Maisie Jackson with a nice kill. But it goes out of bounds. Did you think it was in bounds, Paul? Now it's long. A good block in the front row by Yule. The lead is now 6. A service ace. Bon Lund will call time. As things are starting to look ugly for the Red Knights in the fourth set, trailing by 7. 19-12 in favor of De La Salle. De La Salle playing outstanding on the front line with Kleinschmidt and Travis, as well as Gabrielle Yule, as they're taking advantage of some service errors as well as hits that go into the net. In addition to the tournaments in Coon Rapids, as well as right here at Benilde St. Margaret's, the Red Knights on September 26th will be heading down 169 to St. James to play in a tournament. They will be the only Twin City team to play in the tournament. Other schools competing will be Lake Crystal Welcome Memorial, Worthington, New Ulm Cathedral, Lucerne, Henderson. and the host school, St. James. Maddie Duffy continuing to serve for the Islanders. Back set to Miller. Goes into the net. It's an 8-point lead for the Islanders. Well, we have seen some back and forth volleyball tonight, as well as a series of runs. That's Yule with an outstanding center line hit. The Islanders are 4 points away from forcing a fifth set. It's a service ace for Duffy. Long. And Duffy on the bump. Fong Long wondering what's going on here, as De La Salle's 2 points away from going to a fifth set. Ella Heineman with outstanding front line play, set point, Islanders. One. There will be a fifth set on a kill from Heineman. De La Salle wins the fourth set, 25-12. We will take a break and we'll be back with the fifth and deciding set. Don't go away, we'll be right back with more high school volleyball on Park TV 16.
I'm a wife,
a sister,
and a grandfather.
I'm an office clerk.
I'm a research analyst,
dance fitness instructor,
actor.
I'm a copywriter.
I'm a veteran.
I have lupus,
cerebral palsy.
I'm blind.
And I'm working in a job I love.
I love.
Because I was given a chance.
To contribute my skills and talents.
To show that my disability
is only one part of who I am.
Who I am.
Who I am.
At work, it's what people can do that matters.
For more information, visit whatcanyoudocampaign.org.
Howard Lilloff back at Sauna Lake Haven Center on the campus of Benilde St. Margaret's School in St. Louis Park. As we get set for the fifth and deciding set of tonight's girls volleyball match between the De La Salle Islanders and the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights. The set will be played to a score of 15 points, but a team still has to win by a margin of at least two. In case you just tuned in, the Benilde St. Margaret's athletic family lost a member last week when Greg Herman, the father of Benilde St. Margaret's girls volleyball player, Kate Herman, passed away. On behalf of everyone here at Park TV 16, as well as the St. Louis Park and Benilde St. Margaret's athletic communities, we would like to extend our condolences to the Herman family on the passing of Greg, a Red Knight volleyball booster. They will pay tribute to him at Thursday night's match against Minneapolis Washburn. Against Minneapolis Southwest, De La Salle plays Washburn on their home court in Minneapolis. The Islanders will serve first. In the fifth set, with the Red Knights winning the first set 25-12, De La Salle winning the second 25-19, The Red Knights winning by the same score in the third. And De La Salle with a 25-12 win in set number four. Sarah Kleinschmidt will serve first for the Islanders. The ball was out of bounds and a point for the Islanders. Lung with the back bump. Kleinschmidt. The ball goes into the net, two in a row for De La Salle. Kleinschmidt continues to serve for the Islanders. Sather. Anna Carr, the libero. A sidearm volley by Paige Mazzell puts the Red Knights on the board. Emma Sather is back in for the Red Knights. And she will serve. Goes out of bounds and a point for the Red Knights. It's all even at two. And the first tie in any set since the second set. There were eight ties in the second set. Kleinschmidt. A double hit violation. The Red Knights take their first lead since the third set. As the ball gets some maintenance from a line official. Kleinschmidt. It's all even at three. Second tie of the fifth set. Kleinschmidt. Goes off of Carr. Harris Smith on the kill. De La Salle regains the lead. Sather. Mizell on the kill. It's all even at four, tie number three. There's a block by Mizell and Markley on the right side and a point for the Red Knights. It's a point for the Islanders. They regain the lead, 5-4. In the first of three possible meetings between the two schools. The two schools could meet in the Coon Rapids tournament September 12th and then the Red Knights tournament on October 10th. Jackson goes out of bounds. It's a 2-point lead for De La Salle. Kleinschmidt. Heinemann with the kill. Ella Heinemann playing some outstanding volleyball tonight for head coach Jarrell Tate. And another kill for Heinemann. Heinemann's been on fire tonight for the Islanders as Bo Long takes timeout. 8-4 in favor of De La Salle. As Ella Heinemann has made a couple of key kills in the fifth set. As you look at Feng Wang, the head coach of the Benilde St. Margaret's Red Knights, coming off his best season as head coach last year with a 20-8 record. 4 years ago, the Red Knights have won only 8 games, but in the last 3 seasons, they have improved in the win column. In 2012, they won 15. 2013, they upped their total to 16, and last year they won 20 matches. Smith on the kill. The lead is 5. Manny Duffy serving for the Islanders. Jackson on the kill, it goes out of bounds. And the point for the Red Knights. Mizell will serve. We will see the Red Knights once again on Park TV 16, October 1st. And it's an ace for Mizell. We will see the Red Knights October 1st as they will play at St. Louis Park against the Orioles under new leadership. Their new head coach is former Blake head coach Whitney Maiorato. There's a right side block by Markley. As the Red Knights have cut the lead 9-7. There's the block on the right side of the net. Paris Smith picks up the kill. De La Salle 5 points away from winning the match. Aaron Cole with the serve. Kleinschmidt on the sidearm kill. The Islanders have been having outstanding frontline play tonight from Kleinschmidt as well as Heinemann and Travis. The Red Knights call their second and final timeout of the fifth set. Reminder fans that there will be a high school soccer doubleheader coming up on September 3rd, right here on Park TV 16, with the St. Louis Park Orioles hosting the Minnetonka Skippers. The final of three games in a run through the Lake Conference for St. Louis Park. The only schools they do not play from the lake are Edina and Eden Prairie. Jackson. A net violation on the Islanders results in a red knight point. Long back in for the Red Knights. Kleinschmidt. Jackson. And another kill from Heinemann. She has had three outstanding kills in the fifth set. But the ball goes out of bounds. It's a two-point lead for the Islanders. There's a block on the right side. Kleinschmidt. Heinemann. A sidearm hit by Kleinschmidt. De La Salle is 3 points away from taking the match. Grimacombe is back in for De La Salle. Sather is back in. They did not change the scores. A 4-point lead. Thirteen-9. Jackson picks up the kill. It's a 3-point lead for the Islanders, 13-10. As the unknown 26 will serve. For the Red Knights. Ewell was unable to make the play. Hathaway shot goes into the net. Match point, De La Salle. Ewell will serve. But there's a rotation violation. Called against De La Salle. bringing life to the Red Knights. A back set from Kleinschmidt. Out of bounds. The De La Salle Islanders have taken the match 3-2. What an outstanding high school girls volleyball match between the De La Salle Islanders and the Spinell St. Margaret's Red Knights, with the De La Salle Islanders winning the fifth set 15-2. Well, as you look at the match point, on an overpowering kill. Here's a recap of tonight's outstanding volleyball match. Donnell St. Margaret's in the first set scored the first 8 points. De La Salle came back to go on an 8-1 run to lead 9-8, trail 9-8, but Donnell St. Margaret's pulled away the win 25-12. De La Salle turned the tables in the second set to win, which had 8 ties as the action went back and forth with 8 ties and a number of lead changes. The Islanders would win 25-19. That would also be the score of the third set, with Bonnell St. Margaret's winning by the same score. In the fourth set, De La Salle took advantage of a number of violations by Bonnell St. Margaret's as well as service errors, and won the set 25-12. The fifth set had a number of outstanding kills from Ella Heineman as De La Salle held off the Red Knights 15-12 to win the match 3-2. De La Salle improves their record to 2-0. And they will host the Minneapolis Washburn Millers on Thursday, September 3rd. The Bonnell St. Margaret's Red Knights fall to 0-2. And they will host the Minneapolis Southwest Lakers on Thursday, September 3rd. If you plan on coming to the match, they will pay tribute to Kate Herman's dad, Greg, who passed away last week, with a moment of silence. So there will be a lot of heavy hearts at Haven Center on September 3rd. For our producer, director, Paul Broden, and the rest of our Park TV 16 crew, this is Howard Luloff saying goodbye and reminding you once again the final score in a thrilling match tonight in St. Louis Park, the De La Salle Islanders 3, the Bonnell St. Margaret's Red Knights 2. So long, everybody.